think Fortune's ghost is here. Let's end this now.
I'd be glad to help. But after years of trade, though my mind is keen, my body betrays me. Yes, I've bought and sold it all. Furs and jewels, tobacco and wine, fish and fowl, sugar and spice, the corn, and with it, the Ukopia.
I don't suppose you've any nails, but these ones are shite.
I do not, Daniel. I do not. But I assure you that I have taken note of your demand. When New Eden opens to the world once more, then I shall move to meet your need. You shall have the finest Boston nails. The blacksmith may moan, or he may make better nails himself. This is the way of the world. A bright future awaits us, Daniel.
I look forward to it, Mr. Parris. But if I can't get good nails now, there ain't no future at all.
Good day to you, Squire Parris.
Thank you. But no, sir, it is not a good day.
Show me your wares.
You'll find what you need, I'm sure.
I bid you good day.
Yes, sir.
So, Daniel, what's new?
I take it you have questions. Ask them.
How are things going around here?
You've got eyes, haven't you? Things are going to shite, and we're stuck in it. Even the dirt is giving up. Look at it. Not a seed will sprout. But we won't give up. We'll work the soil till it gives or we'll die trying.
Satisfy my curiosity, if you would. What think you of Kate Newsmith?
It's all show, isn't it? Her sister is the one with the real power. Kate's just a stripling beside her. I suppose she means well, but hell is filled with them as meant well, so take no comfort from it.
What can you tell me about Thick-skinned Newsmith?
I can tell you I followed her here, and I'd follow her further. Without Thick-skin, we'd all be dead in a day. With her, we're the hunters. Without her, we're the prey. Mind you, I wish she'd hurry up and figure us a way out of the shite we're in, because it ain't comfortable.
Goodbye for now, Daniel.
Aye. Try not to die in the meanwhile.
Something.
I was afraid to worry you.
No secrets, we said.
We did. Because this only works if we're together.
Right. Together.
Do you think the Banisher knows?
No. Though I'd not swear on it.
He's no fool. I am no Puritan. He must know that at least.
Hush. Someone's coming.
Banisher, you're back.
Mr. McCraith, my man came back and I hear I've you to thank for it.
Don't celebrate just yet. I know the truth. Your secret is out. I don't know who you are, sir, but you're not Fortune Eden.
Don't be daft.
Askell hired the Puritan master blacksmith, Fortune Heaton. You're none of those things. You're not him.
What do you want?
I'd like your side of the story, madam.
Very well.
What? No. How do we know we can trust him?
We don't. But we must take the chance. It's time.
When you demanded a divorce, your husband threatened you. Was that the first time?
It was the first time I'd asked for a divorce. It was not the first time he had raised his hands to me. I loved my husband once. I thought he understood me. But Fortune was an angry man. He was angry, and I was in his line of sight. No matter who or what had upset him, the full force of his anger would fall on me. Always on me.
How did you two meet?
Funny story. Best you tell it, Nelly.
On the crossing, Fortune was sick. He stayed below deck. When the weather allowed, I would take the air. One night, a voice came from the shadows. I should have run. But something in his tone told me he was kind. I was right. He is as kind can be. We became friends. Dearest friends.
Companionship on the companionway. How very charming.
You're not Fortune Heaton. So, who are you?
I am. To hell with it. You're right, I'm no blacksmith. I, sir, am the fugitive thief Arthur Carty.
But a good man. A repentant, hard-working man.
If I am those things, it's because you've shown me it's all right. I'm doing my best to make a better life. Really, I am.
What were you running from?
Just the legal consequences of my illegal life.
On the crossing from England, something happened. What was it?
I'd had peace and quiet for weeks since we'd been aboard. Fortune was too sick to do anything. I even made a friend. I thought to myself, maybe this new beginning will be good for us. Maybe he'll change. Before we left, I'd sworn he'd never lift a hand to me again. Well, guess what?
We didn't plan on killing him. I swear on it.
Do you regret it? Do you regret any of it?
What would be the point? And if I did, what would be the point of telling you about it? I'd have escaped him in the end, but I'd have had to die to do it. I only killed him so he wouldn't kill me. The blame is on him, sir, not me.
You sent me to find your husband, Mrs. Heaton. Find him I did. Your husband's corpse rots on the ocean floor, and his ghost has followed you here.
I rid myself of him once. What shall it take to do it a second time?
Fortune Heaton, dead as alive, you fail as a husband.
Quick to anger, your cruel brutality left your wife in despair. You treat her as a possession.
They stole my name and took my life.
Tough. But now you'll leave Nelly alone. She's not yours and never was.
My corpse rots in the cold abyss. My skin crawls with worms as the creatures of the deep consume me.
That sounds unpleasant. So it will soon be over. I'm giving you the peaceful way out. Count yourself lucky. Go in peace.
Is it over? Is it done?
Aye. He's gone.
What will you tell the others? Will you expose us?
Will I spill your secret to the camp? No, I won't.
Let us know if you need anything. Anything.
My eternal gratitude to you, sir. Thank you.
Herbs in the windows. Prudence Hake's house, just as Jane described it. It's heavily stained.
In we go then.
Oh, there inside. Anyone home?
It's empty.
She writes well. She also seems to be out of her mind. Who goes into the wilderness to write letters?
I want to know where she learned to write so well.
Three oaks, it says.
Could be where she's gone.
Those are acorns on her table. Seems likely. Nobody home, but the stew is bubbling.
Jane mentioned three oak trees. Perhaps our friend is there. Something's pulsing here. Let me try something. This is unexpected.
Is this house haunted by calculus?
Someone scrubbed the walls. Mrs. Hake must have seen the numbers.
Aye, I didn't much like them. As a cook, this Prudence Hake makes an excellent letter writer.
She's resourceful. Interesting. Let's go find these oak trees and this haunted, well-lettered cook.
secret path into the forest.
This explains how she slips past the gates.
One less to worry about.
Do you hear a French woman?
Aye. She's taking no shine.
Well, she is French.
Is that?
Yes. Something's here.
Something's here.
Hidden.
La prise pour qui? Je ne me laisserai pas faire.
Nothing's concealed. A draft
from the invisible.
Try this on.
Fier maintenant. Who is there? Come no closer.
Easy, madam. I mean you no harm.
Come no closer. Who are you? Why do you follow me?
Red McCraith, at your service.
The Banisher who lived. For what little good it brought.
Are you Prudence Hake?
What do you want?
She's skittish. Why?
I was sorry to hear of your husband's death.
My Thomas was a happy man, whatever you may have heard.
You've hit a sore spot. Press hard upon it.
What are you doing out here in the woods?
I have an engagement with the Queen of Spain. What does it look like I'm doing? You've seen the camp. We are starving. A day without bread is long, and acorns make a good enough flour.
Who were you talking to just now?
What do you mean?
Just now. Your voice was raised. You were speaking French.
That's ridiculous.
Right. Fine. We're doing this then.
You heard wrong.
You won't get her to say it, but Prudence Hake is secretly French.
May I go now, Scotsman?
I'll be plain, Mrs. Hake. I believe you need my help.
I did not say I was Prudence Hake.
She's stubborn. I like that.
I've seen the writing on your walls. You're haunted, are you not?
I've had strange visitors, it's true. You, for example. Stay out of my house. I'm going home now. I mean it. Stay out.
She denies what's happening to her. We'll need proof.
More numbers. They look new. Yet more numbers. Let's follow the trail.
Mrs. Hake seems suspicious to me.
She was as suspicious of you as you are of her.
What's a Frenchwoman doing here in New England in times of war?
Hiding the fact that she's French, evidently.
Some of this. Perhaps as a key.
Numbers. We're on the right track.
Something's nearby.
Where is it? I have another insight.
Did you feel that?
It's close.
godless! Faithless!
Oh, it doesn't like us snooping.
This is a cipher. Has Prudence Hake been sending encrypted messages? She reports the destruction of food rations arriving by sea in New Eden.
That explains the burnt docks when we arrived.
What now?
More stains. Keep digging. So, Prudence is a French spy, and a saboteur, too. But why would the ghost use her cipher?
Maybe the ghost is a spy, too. I feel a draft.
From the invisible. These are not threats.
These body parts scream manifest my specter.
Show your shape in flesh!
Stop that specter before it possesses the corpse.
What is lurking here?
Time to work, Banisher.
Brought more friends.
More messages. A vivid memory from the dead is somewhere near.
Thomas?
You know I'll always love you, right?
The closer you get, the more aggressive it becomes. Thomas found her Huguenot seal. I don't think he knew she was a French Protestant.
Maybe he's protecting her. The French aren't welcome on English land.
This is not English land.
Tell that to the English, or to our ghost when we find him.
They're warnings, or cries for help. This isn't over yet. Red, there is something wicked placed upon this. I can sense it.
You can just sense it?
It's hidden, even for me. But I can hear its dark will, like a curse or a spell.
A curse or a spell, eh? Maybe Seeker could help us with this.
Shite! Wait, we wish only to talk. Brought more friends. Nice try, Thomas.
If you need a rest, this place is as good as any.
What is lurking here?
Time to work, Banisher.
Look at you, unloved and godless, silent, worthless, blood-guilty fool, forever, never-ending mercy by my loving kindness.
No, I cannot. I will not. Prudence, forgive me!
Thomas? Thomas! My God, no! What have you done? Stay! Please! Stay!
He took his own life. His were no ordinary nightmares.
He died a gruesome death. No wonder he's still here.
He is here.